Dave is the owner of the account called Computing Forever. He's put together a presentation video called MGTOWs Becoming Cult-like and Ideological. For the first 4 minutes and 30 seconds, he pretty much summarizes in some detail, good detail as well, as to why some men are going their own way. He goes on, it also brings statistics into the equation and states stuff like,
immensely gynocentric. While modern third wave feminism is thankfully subscribed to by only a small percentage of Western women, it remains politically quite powerful. We've all seen recent examples of false rape claims made by misandrist feminists and social justice warriors.
And so forth. And it's pretty deep and pretty thorough for the very first 4 minutes and 30 seconds. For me, like, when you hear someone talk about, you know, male suicide, false rape accusations, or, you know, sexual molestation, how homeless men don't have any support, etc., etc., it opens my eyes and I start saying to myself, this is dangerous. When you look into the Family Law Act of 1975, no-fault divorce, and you peep the game, you start to step back and say, whoa. You know, when you actually experience it as well, it's like you take two steps back and you say, you might say to yourself, what I've said to myself, I'm not going to get involved in another relationship again because I know what the game's about now. But what Dave's done here is he's flushed it all down the toilet. So he talks about this kind of stuff for the first 4 minutes and 30 seconds and then brings in the armored skeptic and also introduces the mayor of MGTOWN, pretty much speaking about how armored skeptic bagged out the mayor of MGTOWN, and you have Dave Computing Forever pretty much riding that wave. So I'll find it here. I'm on 4 minutes.
Going their own way, avoiding the skewed gender dynamics in relationships and dating and choosing a life of bachelorhood. In a recent Armored Skeptic video, which I recommend you check out, Skeptic criticized renowned MGTOW, the mayor of MGTOWN.
I don't believe the Armored Skeptic is the yardstick, or his thoughts are not the yardstick of measure for people to decide who is a good person and who is not. It's a bit crazy because when I listened to what the Armored Skeptic had to say, not only did he cherry pick some information regarding the mayor of MGTOWN, he pretty much only watched like the very first video that he had, not even scratching the surface regarding the mayor of MGTOWN. And yeah, we are men going our own way. Every man's going his own way, different ways, but we do come as a collective and hang out online or in Hangouts, Google Plus, etc., etc. And we share ideas, we talk philosophy, and pretty much discuss things regarding the future. The reason why I say that is every man that's going his own way is here, not for the same reasons. Why the mayor of MGTOWN is a part of the collective of MGTOWN is not the same reason why I'm a part of that collective. What reason he is here for is different than mine. And what the skeptic, Armored Skeptic, has done is he said, this guy, the mayor of MGTOWN, look at why he's a MGTOWN. Look at why he's a man going his own way. This is disgusting. But why is it disgusting? This is the mayor of MGTOWN's problem and he's dealing with it the best way he knows how. And it should be respected that he's decided to go his own way. And another thing, why don't people like to talk about the good things that a man does? Dave just read out some statistics about some of the things that affect men and yet couldn't appreciate that the mayor of MGTOWN has helped men, not only online, but also in the real world. The mayor of MGTOWN has helped homeless men in real life. Yes, real life. He pretty much had a project going on called the Outreach Project, the Homeless Outreach Project. I believe that was a beautiful thing that pretty much inspired a lot of men within this community, within this collective, to say, you know what, man? Us men, we can help each other. this was a step in a beautiful direction. Skeptic could have talked about something like that, but he chose not to because he's not here for that. He's just here to bag out MGTOW, and to ride on such a wave, it's pretty stupid. Because if you're going to ride on such a wave, then you're going to have people pretty much telling you what you've done is wrong. Another thing that the mayor of MGTOW, or the mayor of MGTOW, has done is he's helped men online via some very, very simple things. For example, fathers that are having a hard time trying to see their kids, trying to make contact with their kids via the family courts, which we all know are a rort. They rort men, they scam men of their wealth and use children as the carrots on a stick. The mayor of MGTOW, for example, this is about a year and a half, maybe 2 years ago, he pretty much threw a sentence out there that I captured and I've left and locked in my mind, and it was, be the cool parent. If you can't be the school parent, be the cool parent. So for me, it's like, yeah, you know, wow, okay, they're not giving me a chance to be the school parent or the parent that I want to be. I want to be involved in my children's lives. I want to be involved a lot more than what I'm allowed to be involved. So you know what? I'm going to be that cool parent. I can't be the school parent. I'm going to be the cool parent. So there are things that do stick, and these things, these memes and these sentences that the mayor of MGTOW has thrown out there have really helped a lot of men. And I mean, I could only talk about the mayor of MGTOW because this is who you speak about, Dave, Computing Forever. But I'm a skeptic. I found out later on that he even spoke about Paul Wilson, and he also spoke about Sexy MGTOW. You can speak about all these other men as well if you like, but there are men that will defend these men. Why? Because these men that are being talked about have helped other men.
He also says that many men are MGTOW but don't know it. As Skeptic states, that's no different to feminists who say...
Man, Skeptic is not the yardstick of measure for anything. Many men are MGTOW and don't know it. It's very, very simple to understand. You don't need to be a genius to understand what that means. All he's implying is that there are many men that have opted out of relationships. It doesn't take a genius to understand what he's trying to say.
Hey, that if you're for equality, you're a feminist. Feminists also criticize other non-feminist women.
By the way, MGTOW, men going their own way, are not men going their own way for equality.
By saying that if you're not a feminist, then you must have internalized misogyny. I've seen MGTOWs do exactly the same thing. When I say things like not all women are gold-digging hypergamists, I'm told I'm being a white knight blue pillar and that I'm Nawalting. You can't...
What I've done for this video, for you, Dave, and for any other men listening that want to know some of the differences between men going their own way and feminism, is I've put a link at the bottom in the description bar. Just click on that link and you'll watch a video that I've put together months ago that was not only put together by myself, in a sense where I put the whole thing entirely together by myself with my information. No, there was a lot of information because it's part one and part two where a lot of men got involved and participated in pretty much clarifying the differences between MGTOW as a collective and feminists and their ideologies.
Win with ideological thinking like that. Now, before you go commenting below with Dave, I'm MGTOW and I don't hate women and I don't subscribe to the mayor's philosophy, remember that like any identity politics movement online, the members within it are sadly often judged by the actions of the lowest, most fringe practitioners of the movement. The idea that...
Again, MGTOW is not a movement. I know that you guys have spoken about this in the past, maybe on Psychological Cynics video, but I'm going to say it anyway. MGTOW is not a movement.
Men are opting out of relationships in society because of how feminized it's become is not the fault of women. It's the fault of the ideologies that are driving society to behave that way. It seems some MGTOWs just refuse to recognize that there are female MRAs out there who staunchly oppose the feminization of the West.
Just because there are female MRAs does not mean anything. Does this mean we should go back to the plantation? I mean, did you forget the first 4 minutes and 30 seconds of your video? Did you throw that in the rubbish bin somewhere?
I can totally understand men who opt out because they recognize how skewed the system is, but that's no reason to blame these issues on 51% of the Earth's population. This level of misogyny is exactly what third wave feminists are feeding off of. As I've mentioned in a previous video, is it not better to simply label yourself as a rationalist rather than a MGTOW?
Whether one blames the other gender or not is not important. What is important is that one does not play, and I'm talking about men, do not play rationalist, humanist, whatever. If we do want to play, we got to go back to that plantation. The dollar doesn't stop at a woman being rational. There is legislation that a man will also have to be, well, a man's going to come up against if all hell breaks loose and something happens in the marriage. Remember the statistics. Remember the very first 4 minutes and 30 seconds of your video.
So there's no point in trying. It'll all end in failure. What a self-defeating attitude. Of course, I know...
It's not self-defeating. It's actually self-preservation.
Funny thing is that feminists also say the same thing.
It's like you forget the very first half of the entire video, pretty much. This is intellectual dishonesty. MGTOW is not about equality. Bachelors, I mean, you go into talking about men, you know, that are going through a phase pretty much, you know, becoming bachelors for a while. You don't get MGTOW at all. You don't. At all. This is permanent stuff. Some men might come in and some men might go out back to the plantation. And even then, these men that leave MGTOW, they leave with a lot of information and knowledge that will save their life. It's like, I've said it in the past before, like a MGTOW induction. They see a little bit better, sharper. I don't recommend it because it's dangerous. It's very, very dangerous, and it may cost them their lives. That's why I personally, myself, and a lot of other men choose to stay MGTOW.